Welcome to the demonstration video of Model Maker for Unity. This package allows you to create a wide range of meshes while using the controls and flows you are familiar with while working within Unity. It works by extruding a two-dimensional shape over either a line, spline, or circular path. These paths can be adjusted directly in the editor and the model will update in real time. And just like the paths, you can also see the changes made to the two-dimensional shape instantly on your model. As the shape is extruded over the path, its height and width can be manipulated by the use of animation curves. These shape-altering curves can be different or the same for each axis and are repeatable over the path, which opens up a lot of potential options while making your model. Furthermore, you can adjust the resolution on key parts of your model to introduce higher fidelity. These resolution changes can be applied manually or be automatically generated based on the curves assigned. Please take a look at part 2 for a more in-depth exploration into these features and more. But for now, I will demonstrate how to make a simple model from scratch with the Model Maker tool. I'll start with adding this asset creation script, which allows me to define mesh creation groups. Our first group I will call Handle and assign a material. Now we add our first mesh creator. Let's go with mesh creator over line. This component allows us to define a line over which we will make a mesh. But to do so, it will need to know what kind of shape to make. For this, I've prepared a variety of two-dimensional shapes to be used, but you can add your own. So let's add a shape component and select a circle. Then connect it to the mesh creator. Lastly, we still need to assign this mesh creator to the group. And there you go, our first piece. Let's make the handlebar a bit thinner and longer. And since it doesn't need to be anything fancy, I will just lower the resolution to 2. And lastly, adjust its edge style to be smooth. And we move on to the next part. Now it's time for the weights on either side of the handle. Let's start on one end, and I will later show how to do the other in just a click. We go through the same steps as before. We add a mesh over line component and add a shape to it, which will this time be a hexagon. Then we define a group, give it a name, assign a material, and in the end assign our mesh overline component. First, I want to make sure that the weight is always connected to the end. So let's put it inside another transform and give that a relative path offset script. By connecting this to the handle, we can now place the weight relative to the handle. In our case, it will be on the end. And to make the weight a bit more interesting, I'm going to add a scale curve component and assign it to both the length and width. Now we can control how the shape scales as it's going over the line. To finish the model, we could go ahead and make a duplicate of the weight and move it to the other side and be done. But now, if you want to adjust the weights, you will have to make the exact same changes on two separate objects. Instead, let's define a bundle. I will make this bundle, assign it, and give it a mesh creator overline to take as its input. Then we tell it where to create this mesh, which will be on two locations. And now we have both weights controlled by one component. And there we have our model. So now it's time for the final step. We have our model in the scene, but this is a generated mesh, and it's not saved yet into our project. At the moment, all of this information exists only in temporary memory. So we have to go to this window, select our asset creator, and hit save. Now we have our model in the project and ready to be used anywhere. And that concludes this video. Please check out the Asset Store page of the Unity Model Maker package, or watch part 2 to learn more about it. Please let me know what you think and feel free to give suggestions for future features and improvements.